Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. We'll start a new topic, and the topic is, you see, an introduction to the diseases of the male and female genital tract. Please keep it in mind. This is just an introduction. It is not, going to cover the subject by any length, you see. I will just give a little bit more introduction, and in some of the places, name the diseases and skip away, because these topics will be covered in fourth year, inshallah, by more competent people. I'm sure by now, you know the female genital tract, uska lower female genital tract kya hoti hai, aur upper female genital tract kya hoti hai, aur male genital tract ke andar kaun se organs aate hai. So, now the topic is introduction to the diseases of the, mostly jo hai, infectious pe, we will not, enlarge upon, because we are already covered the infections which are mostly sexually transmitted of the male and the female genital tract. So let's start one by one, and if I am not able to finish this lecture, I can talk to you, and the remaining portion will be scheduled at some other time. So let's go to the next transparency, and the first organ of the female genital tract, which is, the external organ, is called the vulva. And as you know, every organ has got, the inflammatory diseases, neoplastic, degenerative. So, is tarike se iski bhi jo hai, jo sabse pehli baat hum jisko mention karenge, that is vulvitis. Inflammation of the vulva, it can be infectious, it's not very common, and non-infection is again not very common, but the non-infectious, can present in two patterns. One is contact irritant dermatitis, in which the element of irritation is more prominent. Then another entity which is called contact allergic dermatitis, in which there is participation of the immune system and the participation of the hypersensitivity reaction. Then coming to the next transparency, we will see at some of the non-neoplastic epithelial disorder. The aapko pata hai vulva ki jo covering hai wo skin hai, to epithelium uske andar hai, to uske jo non-neoplastic disorders hai, mainly there are two: lichen sclerosis and lichen simplex chronicus. Ye both leukoplakic hote hai, meaning thereby there is formation of white patches, in dono ke andar. Aur ye dono sirf hi cause nahi hai white patches ki, baaz dafa cancer ke andar, epithelial cancer jo hai, carcinoma ke andar bhi white patches ban jate hain, aur iski ye bahut importance hai, wo main abhi aapko batata hu. The lesions of lichen sclerosis and lichen simplex chronicus, inki biopsy zarur karni chahiye dekhne ke liye ki